And this is the Beo card, VX5000. Many capacitor problems and eaten traces by the rotten traces by the acid. See the black traces eaten by the acid. The fan inside. This is the digital module for the freeze and multi features. No bad caps on this one. So this is the Bang & Olufsen video recorder, the VX5000. This one had a lot of problems. When I bought it, the capstan motor wouldn't run. On the capstan motor were some bad capacitors, and the IC, the driver, motor driver IC was defective, so I replaced the capacitors, the IC, and now the capstan is working. And it had a lot of bad electrolytics on the all circuit boards, and mainly the 147 microfarad capacitors were just leaking electrolytic over the traces, and that ate the traces away, and that caused various problems too. So, but now those two types capacitors are all replaced, so the 100 and this 47 values are replaced, and it's working 100%. So, and then I had another problem. This video recorder has a digital unit. I took it out here, which is for various effects, such as picture in picture, freeze, so it's still image of the still image, and strobe, and you can put the mosaic screen, so you get multiple screenshots of every channel on the tuner. So yeah, some effects. This one produced only black and white, and there are two trimmers here, so this IC with this crystal and trimmer, this is for the receiving part, for the demodulation of the, in this case, the PAL color demodulation. And here we have the same IC with the same crystal and trimmer for the modulation, so the screen that is produced by this digital circuitry is modulated by this IC, the PAL, and then it's sent to the screen. Now those trimmers were both defective. They had some, when you trimmed it, some positions where the oscillation stopped completely. So those are the originals. The black ones, it is 90 picofarad, and I replaced it with those, with the, no, sorry, it's 30 microfarad of the 30 picofarad, and it's yeah, it's not having this problem anymore. So I just adjusted everything according to the service manual, and now we have color. So the problem with the black and white only is solved. So let's put some things into motion. Always like those LED screens.
So, now we have
this. Let's turn down the audio. So we have color now. This was first all black and white. So you can slow it down and speed it up, and so it's really working quite good. Very little noise below, but we can adjust this. It's recorded with a different player, so it's just it's really not performing bad. Also the hi-fi sound is working. Okay, then the picture in picture. So that's working. It's just yeah, all perfect. So this is the bottom of the VCR. This is the capstan motor, and it's not really a beautiful job, but I replaced the capacitors. And I needed to make some new traces, because everything was eaten away by the acid of the coming out of the capacitors. So the IC, the TA8408, is replaced, and most of the capacitors. So that's good. And these VCRs, as well as some other components you connect to Bang & Olufsen televisions, they respond to the infrared that is coming in via the SCART connector. So this one has no eye for infrared. It receives communication from the TV, and there is also other communication for example, to follow to take over all channels of the TV tuner, take it over into the memory of the VCR. It's done by communication, and I have no Bang & Olufsen television, so I made a this infrared sensor. It plugs in behind is a plug. It's called sensor, and there is also a switch in the sensor, so the video knows, the recorder knows there's no bi-directional communication. And all this thing does, it extends the pulse of the infrared from a few microseconds to 200 microseconds. That's the wired protocol. It's just a longer pulse. You can find it in the Beolink service manuals. So yeah, that's that. And then always put some grease in the in the slides there. So for the two poles, for the threading, so the threading mechanism. Some new grease. The slide for the threading mechanism. So one feature I like to show is this recorder. As many video recorders do, is they put a marking on the tape whenever a new recording is made. But this recorder with the built-in digital unit, it can collect all first screens of every recording and put them together in an overview screen. And this overview screen then can be recorded at the beginning of the tape. So that's what I tried with this one. Again, I have my infrared receiver here, so that this works. So now it's going to play the very beginning of the tape. And here, yeah, these are the first screens it captured from each recording on the tape. So, yeah. It's a feature I don't think you see many times. Every button is nicely lit. Record level. When you use the built-in tuner, it's automatic record level, but when you use the line in, you have to set the record level. And you can make very good recordings, audio recordings. So for example, now I made an audio recording. It detects it's audio only and it goes in long play mode, so you can use double the time. And so a 4-hour tape becomes 8 hours of high quality audio. It's the hi-fi system with the audio heads in the video drum. This you see very rarely. The HQ off. Chroma luminance filter.